So let's bring him in for his yoga reaction from Sydney, the leader of One Nation in New South Wales, Mark Latham. Well, I don't know if I want the visual image, but are you going to be doing a downward dog with Matt Keane and all the others?
No, Peter, I'm giving that a miss. I've been working hard today on a whole range of projects and basically also through my office trying to keep up with the tidal wave of complaints and problems and issues out there in New South Wales. If the federal parliament is sitting, it's hard to believe that the New South Wales parliament is not sitting, given that our state has this massive overload of health, social, economic problems, people losing their job, losing their minds, losing their businesses. I mean, it's a real disaster. And it's hard to believe that the parliament would send out a notice about people doing yoga in the Department of Planning, where you'd think they'd have their minds set on new job creation. They've set out a notice about we're at Purple Day on Friday, celebration of sexuality and the whole LGBTI alphabet. Wouldn't you think public servants and the people working in an empty parliament would be focused on how we get the state reopened, get jobs and society moving again? The taxpayers must be pulling their hair out, not really believing that the system could be so disconnected from reality.
Yeah, but this has been the issue all the way along. I mean, they've got secure jobs, no issue they're going to lose their jobs. They've all had pay increases. They're insulated from all the issues of COVID. I mean, you know, they might be able to get their favourite coffee from their favourite coffee shop, but they live in a parallel universe to everybody else.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they talk about privilege in society. The privileged class at the moment are those who work for the government on full pay, mostly at home, mostly not doing a lot. Sending out yoga videos, celebrating gender diversity, sexual diversity and the like. I mean, this is a massive indulgence. And these privileged people should be out there trying to help the private enterprise that's up against the wall, the people losing their jobs. I mean, you've got the entire New South Wales public sector. The state government here is the biggest employer in the state, and it's employing people who essentially are not doing a lot.